guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing y'all how I achieved this cotton candy color on this wig that I customized for my gender reveal. So without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Okay y'all, so here I'm just showing y'all the 613 wig that I purchased on AliExpress from Bangs on Target Hair Store, which I absolutely loved. Minimal shedding, and it was so easy to work with and dye. Alright y'all, so now I'm taking my Got To Be Free spray and I'm gonna spray this all over the lace so that way I can make sure when I dye the wig that it doesn't stain. And you wanna repeat this step twice. Alright, so next I'm going to be taking some boiling water and pouring it into this container. You can use whatever container you want, you just wanna make sure that it is deep enough to completely submerge your wig for the dyeing process. Next, I will be taking the Shimmer Light Shampoo and adding some of that into the container. We are going to use this to tone the hair and remove any yellow tones that may be in the wig out, so that way we can have an easier dyeing process. Alright y'all, so here y'all seeing me giving it a nice little stir or whatever. This is just to make sure that we don't have any shampoo clumps stuck at the bottom of the bin. You absolutely do not want that. After giving our mixture a nice little stir, it is now time to go ahead and dip the wig into the mixture. So as you see here, I'm just taking my wig, dipping it in and out before I actually leave it in for a few minutes to sit and allow the shampoo to do its magic. Okay y'all, so now I'm gonna leave my wig to sit in this mixture for about 10 to 30 minutes or so. Make sure you check on your wig because you don't want any over dyeing. All right y'all, now once that time is up, it is now time to remove the wig from the mixture. And as you can see, homegirl has no yellow tones at all. It is that really pretty icy blonde color that we were looking for. So let's get her washed and let's start this dyeing process. Alright y'all, so now that we have removed the wig, I am now filling the bin with some lukewarm water and I'm just gonna apply some shampoo to the bin and we're just gonna rinse out any excess purple shampoo that may still be in the wig. Now that we are done with that step, it is now time to just give the wig a little rinse. I'm using some cool water and yeah, you just want to rinse out the wig real good, make sure there ain't no more suds or anything like that in the wig. Alright y'all, so now that the toning process is complete, here is the wig. I have put her on a little mannequin head or whatever with the stand so that way I can comb through her, make sure there ain't no tangles or nothing like that in the hair. And like I said, we're just gonna start this dyeing process. All right, y'all. So first thing is first, I'm parting out that section where I want that cotton candy pink hair color to be placed. And I'm just going to part this section out to my liking. And once I do, I'll break that up. So that way, when we dye the rest of the hair, none of the section that I have parted out is affected. Okay. Okay, now moving on to the blue cotton candy hair color for the rest of the hair. I'm going to be adding again some boiling water to my bin. Again, you just want to make sure that it is deep enough for you to completely submerge your wig. And I have my sky blue Adore hair color. I did only use one bottle of this, y'all, because it was all that I had left. Yeah, y'all gonna see it later in the video. We'll get to it when we get to it. Once again, y'all, I'm taking a spoon and I'm just stirring that mixture, making sure there are no clumps. You really, really, really want to make sure that you do a good job with this step, because if you don't, it's going to cause patches in the wig, and we absolutely do not want that. So just make sure you take your time on this step. Don't rush. And yeah. Okay, so once I am done adding and mixing, I am now dipping the wig into the mixture. And as you can see, the section that I parted out, that I told y'all I parted out for the pink part of the wig, I'm just holding the wig by that section so it does not get any of the hair dye on it. And that is how I prevented that section from turning blue or anything like that. I just made sure that I dipped the remainder of the wig in there and left that portion of it out. Okay, y'all, so as you can see, the water eventually becomes lighter in color, which means that the hair has pretty much absorbed all that I have added. So based on the results of what your wig looks like, that'll tell you whether or not you need to add some more, or if you like the results, then you're basically done. But obviously, you can still see some patches and stuff, so I was not done. So here, y'all, I'm basically repeating the same steps. I'm adding in my dye and I'm going to give it a little stir, you know, make sure everything's nice and mixed together. And then we're going to repeat the process of allowing the wig to soak up the color. Okay, y'all, so once that color has been fully absorbed, it's time to rinse the wig. So let's get to it. Oh, and this is very important, y'all. You want to make sure after you have put that color on that wig that you do not use warm or hot water. Use cool water so that way the hair does not bleed. Here were the final results. So as y'all can see, your girl still has some patches. Like I told y'all, I had only one bottle of the Adore sky blue hair dye left, so I had to improvise. So y'all will see what it is I do to fix all of that going on. Okay, y'all, so now we are back again with the bin and the boiling water, because we have to repeat the dyeing process again for the patches. So I'm going in with my Periwinkle Adore hair color. I had some of this left in the cabinet and I was like, well, your girl gotta do what your girl gotta do. So yeah. So once again, I add as much as I think that I need. I'm gonna give it a nice stir, make sure there's no clumps or anything like that, and then we're gonna place the wig into the mixture. Y'all, so now y'all see I'm adding the wig into the mixture, and I'm again holding the wig by the section that I have parted out, and I repeated this step twice, I believe. So once I'm going ahead dipping the wig in, allowing the mixture to soak onto the wig where the patches are, and then one more time. Okay, y'all, so after all of that, I am finally satisfied with the outcome. So it is now time to once again remove the wig and get her rinsed. So now I'm adding, again, cool water. Do not use warm or hot water. I'm adding some cool water to the bin. I'm going to add a little bit of my shampoo and just give the hair a nice good rinse. Here are the final results. Okay, so we are finally ready to work on this section of the wig. I'm taking my Cotton Candy Adore hair color and I'm going to be applying this hair color all over that section that you see. I just want to tell y'all to really make sure that you work that hair color in. Get in between the crevices of the hair and all, because like I said before, you do not want any patches. So that's what you see me doing. I'm just really taking my time and working that hair color into each and every single strand. Okay, y'all, and this next clip is from the next day. I'm pretty sure I got tired and went to sleep, so that's why the hair looks all dry. But anyways, the color has had time to soak in and absorb, so here we are rinsing it out. And don't let me find out you was using hot water, because I already told you to use cool. And now that the wig is completely dyed, it's time to give her one last final rinse. So here I am again with my cool water and my shampoo. Next, y'all, I'm just taking some conditioner and I'm gonna work that through the wig and allow that to sit for about 10 to 15 minutes. All right, y'all, now that that 10 to 15 minutes is up, it's now time to rinse that conditioner out. And here are the results. Oh my gosh, I love it. The color is giving. Despite of what we went through, the color is giving. Okay, y'all, so now I'm really not gonna do too much here. You just see me towel drying the hair a little bit to prevent it from dripping all over the place. I'm gonna go in with the comb, detangle it, make sure she's good, she's straight. And then you're also gonna see me go in with some, there you go, argan oil. And I'm gonna apply that all over the hair. Not too much, because you don't want it to be oily. And I do this just so that way, as the wig is air drying, she doesn't become all hard and dry and crispy. So yeah. It is the next day. She is dry, and this is the outcome. So, boom. I had so much fun customizing this wig for my gender reveal. If y'all like the video, please make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. If you want to see more, then again, like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, y'all stay tuned.